I'm your host, Ricky Saillas, with my friends, Mario Ramirez and Nigel Sherman, who's behind the camera. We're here keeping cool at San Jacinto Plaza in downtown.
Hey, Rick, we have a lot happening across the city of El Paso. Let's get started.
The El Paso Streetcar is preparing to extend its hours of operation starting in September. The streetcar will run from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Thursday and 7 a.m. to 11 p.m. on Friday. It will run from noon to 11 p.m. on Saturday and noon to 6 p.m. on Sunday. Again, the new hours are anticipated to start in September. The extended service hours will provide more options for people to use the streetcar, such as UTIP students who are on their way to class. Riding the streetcar is free. Now, the streetcar will continue to provide special programs like the read and ride with the public libraries and performances with local bands. To find out more about the streetcar, visit them on social media or the website that's on your screen.
Hey, are you gonna go check out that music in the park?
Hey guys, listen up. If you guys know anybody who's interested in starting a career in law enforcement, why not have them join the El Paso Police or Fire Department? Both are hiring. The police department is looking for new recruits for the academy. Men and women from El Paso and around the country are encouraged to join the force. The department is also hiring lateral officers, meaning law enforcement officers from other agencies can apply to join the El Paso Police Department. For more information or to apply, visit joinEPPD.com. If you ever wanted to be a firefighter in the Sun City, now is your chance. The fire department is looking for men and women to fill its ranks. Applications are already being accepted for the Fire Academy. To apply, visit join.elpasofire.org. Two other city happenings, the El Paso Zoo and Botanical Gardens is giving animal lovers a chance to hang out after hours at the zoo. Every Saturday in July, the zoo is open until 8 p.m. and admission will only be $7 after 5 p.m. Visitors can see the animals in the evening while enjoying local bands, family-friendly activities, and lucha libre matches. It's all part of the Lucky 7 promotion at the zoo. Well, when is the last time you visited your neighborhood park? If it's been a while, this month is a great time to head outdoors because July is National Parks and Recreation Month. Did you know that there are more than 300 parks across the city and each one provides something unique? Aside from encouraging folks to visit a park, the Parks and Recreation Department has upped their game by hosting various family-friendly activities in July at different recreation centers. Visit Parks and Rec on social media for a list of activities. You can visit a city park by joining the fun at one of the Music at the Park events happening through September. The next one is Friday, July 7th at the Westside Community Park on High Ridge, then at Armijo Park on July 21st. There's free outdoor music, activity booths, the downtown art and farmers market is also there, and of course there are plenty of giveaways. It all starts at 6 p.m. and runs until 9:30 p.m. So be sure to bring a chair and a blanket and have lots of fun.
All right, come on, let's get this together. Ready?
Here we go.
One, and two, and three.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday
to you, El Paso. What do you think, guys? You think we can win the Happy Birthday El Paso singing contest?
Absolutely, it's in the bag.
Here's how you can enter the contest as well.
Here's what you have to do. Come up with a happy birthday video and tag the city of El Paso. You will then be entered in a random drawing to win two free tickets to see Jackson Browne on July 14th. Now is the time to get creative like our two representatives did. Check this out.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear El Paso. Happy birthday to you.
To you, blah, 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 blah.
So let your imagination flow and send those videos before July 12th. Good luck. In case you didn't know, the city is celebrating its sesquicentennial anniversary. But the question is though, can you spell that word?
That's a pretty crazy word.
I think I could do it.
Well, we asked some folks here at San Jacinto Plaza to spell it. Check it out.
It's the city's 150th birthday.
Okay.
So
I didn't know that.
Celebrating 150 years as a municipality, right?
Okay.
Tell me, how do you spell the word sesquicentennial? Look at the camera.
The word bicentennial?
Can you spell the word sesquicentennial for us?
No, I cannot.
Can you try it?
Say the word one more time.
Sesquicentennial, S-I-S-C-O.
You want me to spell what?
The word sesquicentennial.
Say it one more time.
Is there a Q in there? Q-U?
What was the word?
Sesquicentennial.
Sesquicentennial. continue.
Can I call a friend? Can we go to the next question?
S-E-S, Q-U-E,
Q-U-A.
Sis, quiz, sis, tenu.
S-E-S-Q-U-L.
I never heard of a word like this. This is crazy.
I did not sign up for a spelling bee.
sis, quiz, S-I-S.
Oh my gosh, why is this so difficult?
Q-U-E.
Q-I-S, sis, quiz. Sis, quiz, continue.
I? A, E.
Yeah, I'm an idiot.
Sass.
Sass.
Oh, I hear sis.
All right, try it.
Sass, S-A-S. Sass.
That's a lot of letters.
S-E-S.
Q-U-I.
C-E-N.
T-E-N.
N. I.
A-L.
Bingo.
See, I'm not that dumb.
It's a hard word to spell, right?
Ain't it though.
What a funny video, and what a difficult word to spell, guys.
Very.
All right, spell it.
S-E-S.
Q-U-I.
C-E-N.
T-E-N.
N-I-A-L.
Sesquicentennial. Good job, guys. We'll see you next time on Your City in 5.